Hi everyone and welcome back. So in previous video we covered about some examples on stack, like some coding implementation using stack. We had an array and then we were doing push pop to solve some problems. Okay, so now in the coming set of videos, which I'm saying like 8 to 10 videos, we are going to talk about generic JavaScript questions, a small, or you can say the beginner level coding questions, which are fairly simple, but if we know the tips and tricks, that can be done very easily. Okay, so before that, we should have a good understanding about array, objects, classes, functions, how we are creating the objects, how we are creating, declaring the variables and all these things. So on the same line, what I will do is I will just cover a little bit about the arrays and object, how to iterate an array, how to iterate an object, because if you are writing the code in JavaScript, we will deal with the string, we will deal with the array, we will deal with the objects. Okay, so here I'm trying to write a simple function with the help of array, and I'm writing some helper methods. So you already know how to create an array simply is something like this, or you can also create an array using like const array equal to new array in JavaScript, and you can initialize it. Okay, and then you have all these possibilities like array.prototype. So all these methods are there in array.prototype. So if you see this array, we see all these methods are available: keys, values, entries, map, filter, reduce, for each, includes, index of, join, sum, every. All these methods can be helpful to solve a particular problem. Okay, so here we created a class array, and in the constructor we have initialized an array. Okay, so now if you write a sort function, right, sort function will do nothing but it is going to sort the number of elements. So what we are doing is this dot array, and we are saying okay to the sorting, and we are getting a compare function, because compare function will decide what kind of sorting you need, ascending, descending, right? And slice you will just pass the start and end index. Okay, and then you, because slice is a native method of the array, so this dot array dot slice, here you are passing start and end index. You see slice takes two arguments, start index and end index. It doesn't change in the existing array, it will return you the new array. Then we have a splice, right? Similarly, you can have all these other methods like length. Length is simple. What we are going to return from this is this dot array dot length, right? So now if I just try to talk about this example, if we just try to call it, so how can we call it? Const array equal to new array. Okay, how to create an object, because this is an array class. Okay, we need to take care of this naming because array is already there. So let's put it as a AWR only. So we created our own class with this name, and we are just passing some arguments, and we already know that we are actually using this rest parameter. I mean, we are passing these argument like this, so it is converting that into array, and we are, that is being passed into array. So this is how we are creating array. Now what you can do is you can actually apply a sorting methods and all. Array one dot sort, here you just need to pass the comparator function. Your comparator function can be like this, it can be a minus b, so it will return the array in the ascending order. If you want to keep it in the descending order, then a b return b minus a, right? So it will do the sorting of the array in the descending order. So here you will get 1 2 3 4, here you will get 4 3 2 1, right? Similarly, consider I wanted to create an object array, right? Const obj array, then what I will do is I will just call this class, and I will pass the objects. So in this bracket I will be passing the objects, okay, which is name, Okay, this is same as the argument because finally we are already converting into object, sorry, into array. Hello 2, hello 1. So you can see these arguments are being passed, and using this dot dot dot, we are converting these arguments, because this dot 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 represents that the passed arguments are converted as an array, and that same array we are passing. Okay, so here we can also do the sorting. Now in this particular case, what we need to do is here we are doing a sorting based on the name, right? So here words object array dot sort, we can write our logic, and we already know that this is the comparator function we are writing, AB, and in the comparator function the logic we are going to return is, here we have to explicitly write it, if A dot the property is the name, right? A dot name is less than B dot name. A dot name is less than B dot name, then return minus 1. Similarly, there will be another condition. If A dot name is greater than B dot name, then return 1. Otherwise, return 0. I mean, both are equals, right? So, custom sorting logic we have written. So, so this sort will just do the sorting on these numbers. Okay, so on the name property we are doing sorting, and we will be able to get the output. So this is nothing but a simple array. How we are doing it, you can also do a simple reverse, like you created the array, you created the object like array 4, you pass the objects like this. So array 4 dot reverse, you can call, there should be one method. Okay, reverse we don't have. So reverse is nothing but array, this dot array dot reverse, simple. We can add this method. What this method will do is, this is a way to actually reverse an array. This dot array dot reverse, it will reverse the array and it will give you. So what we can do is, now we got the reverse method. Okay, similarly we can actually take a look on to the string methods, string prototype methods, object, how to iterate an object, how to iterate an array, because these simple examples to just do a slice, splice, sort, reverse will help us to solve programming problems in JavaScript. Okay, so let's take a look on in next video.